The WCA has an equally important job to do as they equip and empower church leaders all across the globe. Lynn and I love these ministries, and we want them to flourish more than anything else in our lives. But it has been increasingly clear to us that they can't flourish to their full potential when the valuable time and energy of their leaders are divided. The leaders of both our church and the WCA need the freedom to get on with the task of carrying out the important missions that God has given to them. Therefore, I have decided to accelerate my planned retirement date from October of this year to tonight. No. Now, this decision, so that you know, this decision was mine and mine alone after a lot of prayer. And eventually, the decision received the unanimous support of the elders and the executive team. Further, I have decided to step out of my usual teaching and hosting roles at the upcoming Global Leadership Summit. This too was my decision and mine alone, prayerfully made. And after I discussed it and we prayed about it as a WCA board, they agreed upon it as well. Now, going forward, I feel the need to look deep inside myself and determine what God wants to teach me through all of this. I intend to continue surrounding myself with wise counselor and trusted friends, and I'm asking them to speak honestly into my life so that I can learn every single lesson I need to learn from all of this. I have complete peace about this decision, and I'm not going to rush this process. Your prayers would be much appreciated during this upcoming season of reflection. In recent times, I've been accused of many things I simply did not do. However, let me humbly acknowledge three things I have done. First, my initial response to some of these recent accusations was anger. I confess to feeling very angry the last few weeks as I watched harmful accusations fly around without any accountability. I felt attacked, and I knew that my loved ones would be hurt by this, and our church would be hurt as well. I sincerely wish now that my initial response had been one of listening and humble reflection. If I could go back, I would have chosen to listen first and then to seek to learn and understand. I apologize to you, my church, for a response that was defensive instead of one that invited conversation and learning. I'm sorry for that. Secondly, I realize now in certain settings and circumstances in the past, I communicated things that were perceived in ways that I did not intend. At times, it made people feel uncomfortable. I was blind to this dynamic for far too long, and for that, I am very sorry as well. Thirdly, I too often placed myself in situations that would have been far wiser to avoid. At times, I was naive about the dynamics that those situations created. I'm sorry for that lack of wisdom on my part. I commit to never putting myself in similar situations again. Additionally, I want to acknowledge that anytime allegations like these are made, they must be received with humility and gravity. I want to affirm to you, I have taken these allegations very seriously, as have our church elders. While some of the stories, as I said, that were about me have been misleading and some entirely false, and while investigations found no evidence of misconduct, I have been sobered by these accusations. And as I said, I'm inviting the input of wise counselors, friends, and family members to help me sort through all of this in the days ahead, and God will guide. If you are wondering if I'm going anywhere, after a season of reflection, I intend to rejoin all of you here in the Willow congregation. Willow will always be my church home.